In this tutorial, I'm going to show you the correct way on how to fade in and fade out video in Premiere Pro. The simplest way to achieve this effect is to use a dissolve, and specifically the cross dissolve or film dissolve. So I'm going to show you the easiest way to do it first. I don't want to waste your time if that's all you're looking for. Make sure to leave me a thumbs up on the video if that's the case. And I'm going to take the rest of the video to explain some other ways to do this technique that may be better for you, and then also the best way that I think is the most fail-safe way to achieve a fade-in or fade-out to black. To begin with, we're going to go to our effects window. If you don't have something like this up, you can go up to Window and Effects. Alternatively, on the keyboard, you could hit Shift-7 and that will bring up your effects window. Then we're going to go to Video Transitions and Dissolve. The two dissolves that you would want to use are Cross Dissolve and Film Dissolve. I have seen a lot of people using the Dip to Black effect for this, but it's actually one of the worst things that you could do for this technique, and I'll explain why later on in the tutorial. So I'm going to start off by dragging a cross dissolve effect onto the beginning of my clip. And as you can see, it starts to fade in from black. You can always change the duration of this effect by hovering the mouse over the end of the dissolve until it changes the cursor to look like this. Now you can click and drag to make it shorter or longer. Alternatively, you can double click the transition, and here you can set a specific duration of your transition. For those that want to know, this is hours, minutes, seconds, frames. So this reads 1 second and 16 frames. Now, instead of cross dissolve, we could also use film dissolve and get a similar result, fading from black right at the beginning of the clip. And I can bring that film dissolve onto the end of the clip right here, and it fades out. I don't know if you personally can tell the difference between a cross dissolve and a film dissolve, but if you really must know, on page 512 on the latest edition of the Premiere Pro manual, it says a cross dissolve can work well at the beginning or ending of a clip when you want to fade in or out from black. On the next page, it says the film dissolve transition is a dissolve transition that blends in a linear color space, gamma equals 1.0. The film dissolve transition blends in a more realistic way. Basically, dissolves look the way that they should. What that means and the differences between them, I have no clue. I'll leave that up to you. But if using cross dissolves and film dissolves isn't your cup of tea, you could also achieve this effect pretty fast by utilizing keyframing and opacity. By default, this line right here on your clips should be your opacity. But if it's not, you would want to right click on this FX and go to opacity and click opacity. Now, if you're on Windows, you would hold control. And if you're on Mac, you hold command. I'm on Mac, so I'm going to hold command. This will change your cursor when it hovers over the line like this to a plus. I'm going to click it once, and that has added a keyframe. I'm going to go to the beginning of the clip and also click to add another keyframe. I'll let go of command or control if you're on Windows. Click and drag that down. As you can see, the numbers underneath the clip, that's what your opacity is going to be and at what time you're actually affecting that keyframe. So I'm going to drag it down, move my playhead over, and you can see that I am now fading in from black just by adjusting the opacity of the clip. You could do the same thing over on the other side to fade out. And the great thing about keyframing your opacity of the clip is now you have much more manipulation of how the clip fades in and fades out. Meaning that if I wanted to add another keyframe over here at the end, I'm going to create another one, and now I can just move this around. So let's say I do something like this where it kind of fades in, and then all of a sudden it fades in really quick. So whoop, and it fades out in a linear fashion. I want to note that not only does Premiere showcase the keyframes here on the clip, but it also showcases what's going on in the effects control window over here. So we can see all these keyframes that we added, and you can actually see the numbers going up and down as you play the clip. Now, I believe the best way to achieve this effect, and most professional way, in my opinion, is to use a combination of the effects I just showed you, along with a new item called Black Video. Let me show you why. For this example, I have two layers that I need to fade in from black at the same time. The lower third title graphic on track 2, as well as the video clip below it on track 1. If you were to drag cross dissolve on the top clip, it will only dissolve in the lower third. So you could bring another cross dissolve in and put it on the clip below. But now you have two cross dissolves going on. That's more CPU that it's going to take away from the computer. And that's just this example. Imagine if I also wanted to add a picture in picture of that lady looking at my lack of juggling skills. Now I have three layers right here. And that's another layer that I would have to bring another cross dissolve on for. This could keep getting even more complex if I added something like an adjustment layer on top to do all of my color grading with. So with all of this going on, doing cross dissolves on every single layer isn't the best option. For scenarios like this, it's better to use black video, and you can create blank black video in the project bin. I'm going to go down to new item at the bottom of the project bin, create black video. Automatically, the black video will be the width and height of whatever the sequence is on screen. So I'm going to hit OK to that. I'm going to drag the black video onto the sequence onto the topmost layer. I'll use the razor tool to make a cut, go back to my selection tool and delete all of the video over to the right. But what we're going to do is kind of the opposite of what we were doing in terms of fading up from black. Now we need to take this black video and actually fade out so it reveals everything underneath it. I'm going to go back to my effects and in video transitions, dissolve. Now we can add that cross dissolve to the end of the black video. I'm actually going to make the black video a little bit longer. Make the cross dissolve at the beginning. And there we go. And just for those of you that want to use a film dissolve, I'll delete this and I'll put a film dissolve on it, add it to the end of the black clip. And in order to fade out to black, I'm going to take my black video, hold Option on Mac or Alt on Windows, click and drag that over to the end of the video. You could also copy and paste it over here or redrag the black video in. I'm going to delete my film dissolve, bring back in the film dissolve, and now we want to fade into black. So we're going to add it to the beginning of the black video. Make sure that it lines up to the end there. And this is what it looks like. Obviously, this is kind of an outrageous example of what's going on screen at this point, but this does represent a lot of what I actually have run into in terms of having a bunch of different layers that are still being used on the timeline when I need to fade out to black. And if you've been editing videos long enough, you've probably run into a situation when you want to hand off footage to another editor. Maybe you want to hand off your footage to somebody that's doing coloring in DaVinci, or maybe they're editing in Avid or Final Cut, but whatever it is, you're handing your project off to somebody else. Especially if somebody's coloring your footage, it's always nice to remove your fades to black. That way, when the colorist does the footage, they can color the full clip. And then you can go back in and add those fades to black afterwards. Now, I've been talking this whole video about fading up and fading down to black, but there are a whole other spectrum of colors in the color spectrum. We can use a variation of the technique I just showed you, and instead of using black video, we can use a color mat. Just to simplify things, let's just work with one clip here. In the project bin, I'm gonna go down here to new item, color mat. And just like before, it's going to do the exact width and height of the sequence that I have up here, which is 1920 by 1080. And after you hit okay, now you can choose any color that you want in the color spectrum. So let's say I wanted to do this bright green for no apparent reason. Gonna label it bright green. Going to drag it onto the timeline. To switch things up, instead of using a dissolve for this first one like we did before, I'm going to utilize the opacity and keyframing. So I hold Command on Mac or Control on Windows, create one keyframe, then I go to the end of the clip and I create another keyframe, click and drag that down, and now we're going to start at complete green and fade into the clip underneath. Why you would want to do something like this at bright green, I'm not sure, but you know, sometimes music videos get kind of crazy out there these days. Now for the end, I'm gonna drag back in our bright green, adjust it. And for this one, I will hit Shift 7, go back to my dissolves, and maybe I'll do a film dissolve. So I want to have it dissolve back in like this, and it goes back to green. And before I go, I said I was going to talk about dip to black, and I'll do that right now. The reason why you don't want to use dip to black, and I'll put it on the clip right here, is because it only starts to fade up from black 50% into the transition, or halfway. So watch this. As I scroll, it's still black for the first 50% of the transition. As I pass that 50% mark, now it starts to fade in your footage. The reason this is happening is because the dip to black is actually trying to reference footage on the left side of the transition. And because there's nothing there, it's treating the first half of the transition as black, which is true because that's what's on this side of the clip. I can explain further by clicking on the actual transition itself and going up to the effects control menu. Right here, we have the two clips that it's trying to reference. And because there is no clip on the left side, it's just referencing black. And you can see from right here, from start zero, it's black, and then when it ends at 100%, it will be the next clip. The only way that you could effectively use the dip to black transition and have it truly start to reveal your clip at the very start is if you were to go to your effects controls and move this start slider up to 50% like this. Now it's going to treat this transition as if you wanted to start the secondary clip 50% in. It's kind of confusing, but I'll just show you what I mean. Notice right now that it is starting to appear after the very first frame. And so that's why I highly do not recommend using dip to black for this effect at the beginning or ending of a clip. It is a perfect solution though for putting in between two clips. So right here, I have the two clips that we've been referencing, me with the corn on the right and the lady on the left. And now if I go to my effects controls and do dip to black, put it in between both clips, now I scroll through and at the halfway point, it is exactly 100% black. And now it will start to fade in my clip of horribly juggling corn. If you are one of the select few that have made it this far into the video, thank you. I hope you are now well-versed in the ways of fading up and fading down to black. Until next video, my name's Javier Mercedes. I do video tech tutorials and gear reviews on this channel. You can hit the subscribe button if you're into that kind of stuff. And I hope you guys are out there living that life of abundance. Bye. One of the most longest-ist videos about fading to black ever. Oh, this is going to be such a long edit.